Everything on TV is up to shit. Don't like it. Crap. Not my liking. If they put better shows on, I watch it. If they don't, flush it down the toilet.
Nothing on there at all.
Timmy, did you rubbish. Not do your
bloody rubbish.
Come on! Mr.
Garrison, haven't you wouldn't piss off if they were on fire.
Don't call people names, Stanley.
But he is.
Now, Timmy.
I'm going to make a good show, TV show. The show is romance and finding love. Movie you're going to make for these two girls in it.
One, two, three, four, five.
Two spunky girls, two Sheilas.
Sexy devils they are.
Very special, okay. Very nice, sexy looking. We'll be going on a pub crawl, go to pubs, go to strip joints, whatever they want to do. I don't know.
Bloody girls.
It's a love story, mystery, Malcolm TV show.
Mm-hmm.
Love story.
Mm-hmm.
Work is never done. Bloody woman, need a woman to do this. This is my show, I'm making this movie, Down Under Mystery Tour, with two cheeky babes, hot babes. There we go. Hit the road, Jack. Never come back, no more, no more.
Who's going bloody watch it? The whole world, I hope. Everybody. I'm the director, I'll run the show. I'll run the show to make these movies. I'm the boss at it.
I've been a producer for about 5 years now, professionally. I've made a lot of documentaries and some short films, feature films. Out of the blue, completely, in the mail, I received this proposal from Malcolm, and it's just great. Not too sure about the girls, the half-naked girls on the front, but, you know, that's OK, we'll work with that. I have gone through and just, you know, made a couple of small changes, some suggestions, but this is what really excites me here. Malcolm has a mild intellectual disability. This is just great. It's wonderful. There's lots of funding that you can get for people with disabilities. I've had a bit of a look into it. You'll see that we'll be able to go through this and tick every box and we can get the money, which means we can get this project made. And I'm not going to be losing money. We might even be able to get someone who's a regional person with a disability, so that ticks another box as well.
Good morning, who's that?
Malcolm, hi, it's Simone here.
The producer.
Producer, what do you want?
You sent me your proposal for Down Under Mystery Tour.
Any problems?
I think there's some great stuff in there. I'd really like to sit down and have a conversation with you. The
girls on the front cover.
And the sexy chicks as the characters.
It's probably not the way I would recommend going.
Oh, right, eh?
I'm thinking
we get a couple of men, a couple of guys,
who have some mild intellectual disabilities as well.
And we have them as our two characters, our two stars travelling around.
Well, they're bloody fruitcakes. What do you want them going there for?
No. Trust me on this one, Malcolm.
No chicks, two boys. Okay. And we get these two boys to go to the strip joint or else.
Strip clubs? So you want the two characters to stop at strip clubs along the way?
Look, that's probably not the way to go with this story, I don't think.
But if that's something that you would like to do in your own time while we're out on tour, that's fine. I can help
organise that for you. All right, then. Well, thank you.
Bye.
This is my brother Gordy. I love him. And I'm making a TV show. I haven't got my mum, but she loved him.
Love story. We're making love story. Gordon loves them too. What are you watching?
I'm watching the love story, Malcolm.
Rolling.
Action.
Welcome, everyone. We're going on a trip to Down Under, and we're going to find everything and find out all the thing about all the Yowie UFO and
Kapang Rock.
Yep, Min Lights.
Min Lights.
Down Under.
Down Under.
Have you been to Down Under before?
No, I've only been to Sydney.
We had a phone call about someone wanted two guys for a mystery tour. And I thought, yeah, why not? Let's do it. One day, when we be on TV, the people not going to leave us alone because they come over, they want autograph. When James and I walk down the street, they say, "Hey, look, they're doing the James."
Cheer, mate. Oh, I would like to be famous then. Everyone the would notice me, but it doesn't matter if I'm famous or not. It doesn't matter. I don't really care about mysteries. I'd rather find a girlfriend. Maybe I might find a girlfriend on a mystery tour.
Yeah. No, not yet. Us two, we're going to find everything out of everything.
Yeah, we're going to find out and we're going to do some research and we'll find out and tell people, solve the mystery so people don't have to worry about them anymore.
Yeah.
So people can just move on with their lives and continue their lives in peace.
And we're going to be fantastic and exciting and...
Exciting.
Oh, yeah, I cannot wait to go.
It's going to be really exciting.
Yeah.
Hat! Rubbish, no good. Bloody useless. Rubbish.
They are not very funny at all. Another bloody full quid.
Yep, I've got everything.
You tell them what to do, they do something next. Everything. They do something different altogether. They don't get their act together.
Let's go! We off to see the Yowie. Oh God, I cannot wait.
Same
can
here.
Yowie country, here we are.
I wonder how the Yowie will react when it sees us.
Oh, I don't know, James.
Do you think the Yowie might destroy the vehicle?
Oh, yeah, maybe.
Keep going.
Cut.
Well, I got the call about this film and I was told we'll be going on an adventure with a small crew and two good-looking birds. And for me, that was just like a dream come true.
Pull your finger out.
Sort of jobs I mainly work on. As I said, RAF TV was a highlight of my career. So I'd be really interested. You know, I was hoping this would be a step up for me, but it hasn't been. I want to do sound for good TV. That's what I want to do. And this isn't good TV. I don't really think disabled people should be on TV. To be, you know, like, when I was doing RAF TV, you could tune in, you'd have a bird there with a bikini telling you the footy scores from the weekend, having a tinny, you know, watching that. Why would you want to come home on a Sunday night, have a beer and be watching disabled people on TV? Like, there's, you know, like, there's a few times I've been sitting there with my girlfriend, she's made a really nice meal. And, you know, steak and eggs or something for dinner. We've sat down, put the TV on, I see a disabled person on TV. I can't eat. She gets upset. TV's off. It just ruins the whole night. I'm a bit worried about doing this show because you get labelled very quickly and I don't want to be known as a guy that does disabled boom operating, basically, and that's what I'm worried about.
We're here to talk to
Dr. Helmet.
Dr. Helmet.
Dr.
About
Helmet.
The Yowie.
Yowie expert.
So we're here to talk about Yowie. Yowie. With you.
Ah, yes, yes, yes. I know something about the Yowie.
Good.
So please come in.
Okay, thank you.
And that shows the size, much greater, much bigger than human beings. Shows that he's hairy all over.
And scary too.
And scary too, yes. But there are testimonials here in these books of people who have seen Yowies clearing fences. Just like kangaroos do, you know, jumping over them.
If me and Darren catch you out, would it be the happiest day of your life?
Oh, not necessarily the happiest day in my life, but I would be very glad if it could be done.
Glad. Yes.
A final word on Yowies from?
From you!
Who says? Yowies do exist.
Oh, wow.
So, now you have it in print.
Yep.
You must believe it.
Yep.
Believe
it.
Now, this is where I was standing with the first encounter.
Yeah.
I was standing here, and it was standing behind that tree over here.
Oh, my tree.
Nice. Yeah, the first time. Mm. So, down here, this is the track it made. Look at this one.
Looks like a tree to me.
Okay, what are those?
Oh, it's there.
See him there?
So,
see
up here.
That's it.
Now, we had the New South Wales police confirm the height of that.
A berry.
No, it's not a berry.
This berry we are trying to do is no useless, no good at all. The boys are bloody useless, not worth two bob. Get rid of them two blokes and get two new chicks in it, yes.
So one of the things we need to take is this.
Yeah?
What's this look like?
Telephone.
A Yowie caller.
Telephone? Yowie caller.
Yep.
Mate, so, Yowie caller. Like this, hold it out like this. What do you think this might be for?
To measure the
footprints. A measure the footprint.
Yeah. Well, to see how long we're going to be away for. Long time.
Yeah, you're funny.
That's supposedly the mating call of the Australian Yowie, but when I go out in the bush and do that, I don't hang around long because I don't want a horny male coming for me, do I?
Oh, wow. How you know it, horny?
Hey, girlie. How's it going?
Hi, Malcolm. How are you?
This show, it's a love story. Mystery.
Yes?
Yes. There's too many blokes in it.
Yeah?
I want you concentrated on this program here.
This strip club?
Yeah, we go to it and have a look.
I don't really think they're going to know about the Yowie at the strip club, though. It doesn't really fit in with our script, does it?
Can we give it a go? Give it a go?
I'll see what I can do.
Yeah, do your best. Do a good job, okay?
Yes, I will.
People don't think I can make people laugh, but I can. I can tell jokes and I can make people happy. I can make people laugh.
But funny?
Rubbish. No good. Cut.
Well, James, let's go look for the Yowie.
All right.
I reckon I'm funny because I'm funny. I don't know how, but I am funny. Oh. Oh, shit, there. Oh, well. Okay, Rob. Up.
Cut. Rubbish. No good. Rubbish. Stop filming.
Okay, let go.
My foot's numb, Darren.
Well, stand up. Put blood in it. Yeah, back it up. Okay.
Bloody useless. Pair of knuckleheads.
Shit. Ready?
Yeah.
Walk on it, walk on it. Walk on it, I got you. Walk on it.
Bloody James and Darren, useless.
I'm actually a bit not sure about catching him because he's a bit shy around people. If he's caught, he'll be teased, he'll be poked at, people will poke things at him, people he'll be teased at. Yeah. But I don't think Yeah, we wouldn't be like to be caught. I think it likes to be I think it likes to be left alone. Left in peace.
Malcolm.
Hello, girlie.
Simone, I've been chatting to the boys and they don't want to solve the Yowie mystery.
Right. I don't like it. Making sack. Get them sacked.
No.
OUT, out of the show.
No. Right. We can't do that. They're contracted. They've got to do 26 half hours. They can only be sacked if they bring the show into disrepute by doing hard drugs, downloading internet porn, or engaging in promiscuous behaviour with prostitutes. We don't want to lose our funding. We need to keep them.
Mm-hmm. So in my head, I don't like them.
Well, we're keeping them.
They're not solving the mystery. They're useless. Out of the show. OUT. Quit. Out.
And no, we're going to keep them. Okay? Hmm? That's it. We're keeping them.
All right.
All right.
You can piss off now. Ring me.
Shopping centres are probably the worst time to be near disabled people because you can walk into a store, just going to buy, I don't know, a pair of shoes or something, and there could be disabled people right in front of you and they're just trying on the same pair of shoes as you. I mean, they should have. There's disabled toilets, right? You've got men's, females, disabled, and that's fair enough. Like, if you go into a shop and you're trying on some clothes, men's change rooms, women's change rooms, disabled change rooms.
I used to have a really close friend called Cameron Gillespie once, but I still lost contact with him. I had lots of other friends, but I'd lost contact with them all. Well, I did have their phone numbers once, but I sort of threw them out because I lost contact with them. But I am trying to make some new friends.
Look at it. Oh, thank you. Yeah. We've got a problem with these two blokes.
Yeah, mate, we've got a massive problem.
A massive problem, all right.
What are we going to do about it?
Get rid of them.
Absolutely. Well, from what I heard, I don't think we can get rid of them. I don't think we can sack them. We've got to make them quit.
Make them quit?
Yeah.
Put ants in the tent or something?
Ants in the tent, mate, whatever you want to do.
Yeah, whatever to.
You know, do something to the car, do something to the tent. I don't give a fuck. Let's just get them out of here and start again.
Now, these two boys, I can't sack them. I'll make them quit, make their lives miserable, so I'll make them quit. Had enough, over my head. Okay. Special people. Special my ass.
Maybe we're going to find some girlfriend for you, hey? How you look there?
We might find a girlfriend.
Yeah. What colour hair? Blonde? You like blonde hair or?
I like blonde hair.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, big, small, skinny, chubby. What,
skinny.
What shape?
Skinny.
Yeah.
Right, go up there. Go in this property, knock on the door. But there's a problem. There's five vicious dogs.
How many?
Five mongrel dogs. They can take your leg off, take your arm off, whatever. If you don't want to do the job, you quit out of the program straight away.
Yes.
It's up to you. I'm not putting pressure on you. It's up to you. You want to do it? If you don't do it, you have to be quit out of this job.
Come on, James.
Okay, Malcolm.
James, get your shirt on. Turn it, please.
Are you going in, James?
Yep.
Look, Chloe. Hello?
Hello.
Anyone there?
It was that close, like from here to the fence, and being that big.
Yeah.
And I stopped the truck, and I held the gun out the window and faced it exactly where it is, and I shot it.
Do you
I know that that bullet went through it, but nothing happened. It just continued.
Oh, wow.
I wasted two bullets for nothing.
Oh, no.
Jimmy?
Yeah.
Jimmy.
Jimmy. Question, are there any single girls in this town?
Single girls in town? Not with their kids.
Debbie was my girlfriend. We've been for 4 years. My mother didn't care for her, didn't look after her, no one liked her. So I looked after her for a while. Oh, she was my girlfriend. I used to get a rid every fortnight. We had a bit of fun together, but no more fun. Government health locked her away. Put away. She went silly, loopy, bad unit. I haven't got Debbie no more. I had to go find another fish in the sea. There's plenty of fishes in the sea. Go catch it. Debbie said I got brain damage, and she's bloody bullshit. She's locked up, I'm working. Yeah. I do this for a reason, because I don't like them two pair of bastards. They won't get into this bloody door again.
Door not locked.
Come on.
Darren, having sex.
Right, I've got these two dogs made up. Darren and James, voodoo dogs. I had enough. Malcolm, Darren, is that you?
James, shut up.
Hello?
I'm just going to do a test on you.
Okay.
Can you feel that? Darren, did you get that? Bloody useless. Take that out. Didn't bloody hurt.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, who are you fellas?
Do you reckon the Min Min Light is a alien or not a alien?
Nah.
No. Why do you think that?
Because I don't believe in aliens. And I reckon it's gas.
Have you got that, Jane?
Yep. I put kangaroo dipulites. Yep.
Okay, you boys, jump out of the cliff. Too easy. Anyone can do it. Too easy. One big jump, you're over.
Malcolm.
Oh, hello, love.
Hi.
You got a problem?
Did I hear something about a cliff?
Yes, you did.
Oh, no. No jumping.
Okay.
No cliff.
Leave it up to you.
No, I'm leaving it up to you. Go tell them, no cliff.
No cliff.
No jumping, okay?
Okay, I got you, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Get back to me.
Alrighty.
Well, I seen one time ago when I was out in the station, and I seen it's coming down the road.
Yep.
Hmm.
When you went back in town and tell everyone you saw one, did they believe you or did they go, no, no, you're pulling my leg?
Oh, they probably said, you've been in the pub too long. That's what happened, yeah.
Some people said it true, some people say it not true. What do you think about it?
I reckon it's true.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you for that.
Thank you very much, sir.
Hi, I'm Darren.
Hi, I'm Annie.
Yeah, I'll make a move on the girl.
Kendall.
But first, we got a few dates first. Just know her, know her girlfriend a bit more before I make a move. Because you don't make me straight away, because you have to know a bit, bit more first before you do that. Because that's how the system works. It just takes time. Just want to give it time to happen.
Are there any single girls in the town?
Single girls in town? Well, there's one right there.
Oh, wow.
I don't know, I think there's a few.
Because turn something straight away and it'll get all on a bit weird and unusual. Yeah.
Can I ask you a question, mate?
Yeah.
Do you like dingoes?
Yeah. You do? Do you think they should be shot or left alone?
Left alone.
Left alone, why?
Is it cruel if we skin them?
Seriously, this time we've got to take it to the next level. We've got to do something. We want them off the set, gone.
Yeah, we both do. All what right. Are we going
to
do?
I don't know, it's up to you.
I'll leave it to you?
No, I'll leave it to you.
All right.
All right?
Pair of bloody knuckleheads. Very interesting.
two blokes, I want to get killed, get off, you know. I want to get rid of them, take them out, shoot them, drug them, poison them, drown them. You know how, you know, where you come from. You know how to do it. They do it over your country, lot of killing. Violence. Are the bombs going to work? Or was the bastard blowing up?
Rolling!
Yep. Action!
Didn't bloody work.
You don't know anything about anything, right?
Bloody useless bloody thing.
Well, tell me about it.
I tell you, alien, okay? The UFO here, alien here.
I don't agree with you, Darren.
Most people do not lie.
People want something to believe in, Darren. Or they just their minds playing tricks on them, Darren. They're just saying things, so it's just their imagination, Darren.
Well, what do you think it is?
Just gas from the ground.
Where'd that gas come from?
The
you
ground.
Did not say that before.
Einstein, it's just gas, Einstein.
Who bloody Einstein?
It's gas.
It's a
everyone
bullshit.
Knows.
I haven't solved bloody nothing. They're two useless boys like tits on bull. I don't know why. Tits on bull. But the bull's got no tits. I need one professional bloke to do this job. No amateurs, professionals.
We used that photo to illustrate to people what the cat might look like, because all of the people who are seeing the cat tell us it's big, it's black, it looks kind of mean.
Me and Aaron do catch the cats, and we'll bring it to your office and we'll show you a panther.
What, are you going to have it on a lead or in the cage?
Cage.
Yeah, please. Yeah, don't bring it on the lead.
I won't.
I think it could get ugly.
Me and Dan won't do that.
Yeah. Fantastic. Oh, that'd be great. And we can do a nice big front page story about you two.
Yeah.
And then we'd be really famous, hey?
We will.
Intrepid duo catch cat.
Wow. What does that mean?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, wow. Yay. Be on the paper.
Yeah. Yay. Just printed off a front page here for you.
Yep.
Fantastic, look at that.
Oh, yeah, big, in a big light. Darren and Jane phone cut. Maybe we're going to be in the front page on a paper. That'd be excellent. That means everyone can read it and we'd be really, really famous. Everyone notices us and wine, drinking, party all night. Oh, yeah.
People would invite us around for the after dinner. Yep, people will come approach us in the street and to want an autograph. People will treat me differently, much different to when I was back a long time ago. People will treat me differently.
Hello?
Hey, mate.
Hi, what's up?
Oh, these two clowns, I want you to knock them off.
Their names, or a name?
James and Darren, the bloody clowns. I don't like them, but I want to get them off the set.
Okay, it's going to cost you.
Cost a bit, eh?
$10,000.
$10,000. 10 G's.
It's $5,000 per head.
You do the job right, you get paid right.
There is a slight problem. Malcolm, I do have to bring my carer.
Carer? Yeah, is she spunky or what? Is she good looking?
Reasonable.
All right, bring her along. If she's pretty enough, I'll give her $500.
Name the time and the place and I'll be there.
Tomorrow afternoon.
Shoot them out.
Okay. Bye.
Now, that's good. You get the job done. Very good.
Hi, my name's Carla. I'm David's carer. We've been together for quite a few years now. Oh, it's kind of almost embarrassing to say. I mean, the connection we have is just so special. I really am very lucky. Like, you know, sometimes on special days, like, I'll stay over and stuff, so. Yeah, I don't want to leave. It's, yeah. And I mean, he's so funny. Oh, you should, like, I don't know if you will, because he's a bit shy, but oh, his stand-up comedy routines, man, oh, man. Shooting stand-up comedy, shooting stand-up comedy. I don't know, I think there are a lot of people that kind of have two sides to their personality, but are not brave enough in themselves to explore that.
Hang on,
I think he finds humour in the hunt, even. As the hunter, he laughs and mocks his prey and, you know, I think as a stand-up comedian, I think a lot of the time he considers his audience to be his prey and he is still the hunter.
David, it's me. Can I help with anything? Bathing, showering?
No.
People say it's a hard job. It's not a hard job.
Okay.
I'm blessed. I have a funny man who can hunt for our food.
David, why can't we be in the same car? I don't understand.
Because you distract me.
If I promise not to touch you, can I be in the same car as you?
No way that's going to happen.
Big cat's here. Scratches the tree. About there like that. All the way down here like this.
How loud was the panther's growl?
The growl, well, I've heard it scream for a partner.
Yeah.
Yeah, what does it sound like?
Oh, it sounds like 1,000 tomcats on steroids. It's huge.
Can it be patted?
No, this is not a feral animal, this is a wild animal.
What you up for?
I can't find the furry thing for the boom. You know the thing on me, though, it goes...
Yeah, the furry part.
Yeah,
I found it.
Did you take it?
No, I found it.
You sure?
Yes.
Sure you didn't take it?
No, I didn't take it, I found it. Positive.
I'm pretty sure he found it because he stole it.
Did you find it, yeah?
Yeah, James had it. Because he stole it. I don't know, I saw a thing on TV ages ago about disabled people, crime rates and statistics and stuff, just basically saying disabled people steal, I don't know, they're just criminals and...
Let's get move on and do a take, eh?
Right. We can shoot again.
I felt something nudge the back of the car and what appeared to be some type of black shadow walk in front of the car, probably about 8 feet in front of it.
Mm. I heard
that. And then I realised my window was down. A lot of people out there think it's bullshit, but it's not.
Yeah?
Yeah. You get people start saying things to you and you think, oh, well, piss off. What would you know? You don't live up there. You don't...
Nah.
I've bloody heard it. I do. I love him.
Yeah.
I'd have him as my pet if I could. I've had dreams and that I will see him again. Because Chris knows I'm psychic.
Oh, yeah?
And I've had visions of seeing him.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, can you see him now?
No, just of a night when I go to bed. I see myself, him walking down my driveway, and I walk out the front and I see him there and I'm not scared of him. I pat him on the head.
Oh, yeah?
And we walk away.
Wow.
Wow. Isn't this just the best place?
I suppose.
Oh, a romantic place for our special day, David.
I'm busy. I've got a job I have to get done. I don't need any distractions from anyone right now. I've got a lot riding on this.
But we see, if I hold that gun, then we can hold hands and...
No, it's okay. I've got it.
You're hiding?
Yep,
I'm hiding. Put the mouse down for the cat to get it. Oh, ready? Let it go. Oh, not go very long. Let's do it again.
All right.
Are you hiding?
Yep. Look, well, buddy.
We're going to get the mouse with the mouse. Yeah, oh, shitty buck.
Cut!
It's a dead mouse.
It. Don't like it.
Well, we can skin it.
Useless.
Crap. And then what we do when we skin it?
We eat it.
Rubbish. Stop filming. Cut.
Oh, David, isn't this just beautiful?
Yeah, I got a job I need to do.
Beautiful green trees and blue sky and the birds are twittering. It's just perfect. It is a perfect special day for our romantic picnic. Look, and I even brought the special rug, the one with the plastic on the back so that we don't get piled.
I just need to have a bit of quiet so I can concentrate.
Well, you know, David, this is my day too. Like, I've spent a lot of time organising this, and this is really quite important for me.
Yeah, I know that.
Do you want me to bring your rug a little bit closer over to mine?
It's all right.
Okay. Can I bring my rug a little bit closer over to yours?
I need to have a bit of space between so I can concentrate and focus on what I've got to do.
Okay, I understand.
As long as there's no one talking around me, I can focus on what I'm meant to do.
Well, I can be quiet. I can be quiet. Would you like a cup of tea or a coffee? Because I've got the thermos in the car.
Action!
We're here to put the mouse down to lure the cat in. Where's the milk?
I forgot.
Well, go back and get it. Oh.
Useless. Bloody niggerpiece. Useless. Cut.
It's time for your medication, David.
Not now.
What was that?
I don't know.
A sandwich?
What happened?
There were gunshots.
Hey, Malcolm.
Hey, what do you want?
Malcolm, are you trying to kill us?
Yes.
How are you going to dispose of our bodies?
Don't know, meat works.
How do you think me don't have any talent?
None at all. You're like flower pot men.
Flower men, fair enough.
In the army, I wouldn't put you in the front line, I'll put you in the back.
Okay, back line.
Back line. What do you think about two sexy girls coming on the scene?
Pretty good.
We go to strip joints.
Yep.
We go to bars.
Malcolm.
Yes.
Are you trying to kill us?
Yeah, we've been through that.
This is all the cat picture on the wall here.
Oh, good wall. A lot of things there.
Now they cut...
Darren?
Yeah?
We're never going to catch this cat, Darren. Seriously. You're kidding yourself, Darren.
We got lots of brain.
Oh, damn. Oh,
I don't know what we do now.
Let's leave the cat here, and we'll go to the next mystery.
Who's our character?
He's some sort of activist. James called his mother and said you were trying to kill him.
Yeah? Are we in a bit of trouble now?
Yeah. Could be in a bit of trouble.
Ever since I was a kid, I always felt there was something around me. You know, like, and my mum used to say, oh, it's just your guardian angel, or it's just butterflies, or it's just, you know? And I kind of felt that it was a bit more than that. Over there, there's one over there in amongst those trees there. Definitely. I keep being drawn over there. So definitely there's something over there. Definitely. The first thing that you probably need to do is you need to kind of stand really still and see if you can feel anything around you. So just stand really still for a minute and see if you can feel anything. Can you feel anything around you?
Nah.
I can sense one near us now, but I can tell you, you probably will not see it until I actually take the photograph.
Yeah. No way.
Yeah. That's what happens to me. That's great. That's excellent. I can see something behind you, Darren.
What?
There's actually like a shimmer of light just behind you.
Yeah, okay. Take that photo. How about?
I took a photo. I reckon when it comes out, there'll be like this amazing shimmer of light right behind you.
Yeah, okay. Can we move now?
Yeah, you can move. Come forward. I took a photo just at the base of Spook Hill.
Yeah.
And it came out black, completely black.
Do you think you're just a really bad photographer?
Hey, hoods, get away! The muggles, get off! Hey, buggers.
I represent the Committee for the Protection of Disabled People on Film. Now, that is why I'm here. Complaints have been voiced about improper practices involving the two young chaps that have here, two disabled people. Now, it is my job and the committee's to protect them. Maybe to protect them from themselves, really. They may not like it, but that's the way it's got to be. They've got to be protected. Maybe I'll have to close down the whole operation, but that's in the future. We'll see. We'll see what brings.
But the reason Spook Hill is special, I guess, and why people call it spooky, is because it looks like a hill, and it is a hill, but things roll up the hill. Now, I've done the measurements, and there is a definite hill. From down here, on the south side, up to the north side, there is a definite gradient going upwards. I've done actually a measurement from sea level on this side, so I have an exact measurement of where we are at sea level on this side, and then up the other end, and it does go upwards. The ball should really roll back this way towards us because the slope is coming down this way, the gradient is this way. Mm-hmm. So by putting the ball down, the ball should roll this way and should definitely not roll that way.
No.
Because things don't go uphill, do they?
It does.
So we just go. And they just continue to roll and roll and roll. And they're going uphill.
Wow.
Which I can't say why.
Do you think our mystery fund roll up to?
I imagine it would have to. If the balls roll up there and things go up the hill, then I would say, yeah, that the van will go up too.
Thankfully, we've managed to get an emergency counselling session. Poor David, his confidence, it's just shot. You know, he has missed on previous occasions, maybe once, maybe twice, but never like this, and this was an important job, so I sort of tried to indicate to the counsellor that, you know, we're not talking about mamby-pamby, you know, paintball stuff, you know, this is serious. killing is what he does and killing is what he needs to do. He needs to finish this job. Can I help with anything?
I don't think I could really ever see myself having a disabled friend. Actually, I know I couldn't. I just couldn't go out in public with a disabled person. There's just... You can't even talk to him anyway. Like, what's the point?
What's up? Hey! What's up, mate?
How you doing, man?
Hey, boys, how are you?
Yeah, good. We're just in town.
What's going on?
Not much. Hey? What are you up to?
Oh, I'm just working away.
I definitely couldn't tell my mates I was doing this show. There's just no way. They still think I'm doing the sort of soft porn thing. But yeah, look, to be quite... it's embarrassing for me... Mates, missus, parents, everything.
Hey, who's Noddy?
Oh, I don't know, just sat down.
Ah, yeah, right.
No idea.
Well, mate.
All right, dude. All right. See you later.
See you, boys.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm not desperate for friends. I'm very selective with who my friends are. I don't become friends with anyone. I only become friends with people that want to be friends with me.
Yeah. How many ghosts are here?
Well, I reckon there's about 30 of them, James.
Are they the ghosts from all the dead people?
Well, there's 120,000 people buried here, so there's not that many of them haunt the place. I've seen maybe half a dozen times I've seen a ghost in the cemetery grounds.
Oh, no!
Fuck. Pardon me.
What we're going to do is simple. You're going to get in the car.
Yeah.
You're going to put the car into neutral.
Yeah.
You're going to take your foot off the accelerator.
Yeah.
And then you're going to release the handbrake.
Yeah.
And when you do, the forces from beyond will grab the car and begin pulling it up that hill. You ready? Are you sure you want to do this?
Yes.
Honor?
Hello?
Oh, they're filming at present. No. No. Not funny at all.
Hang up the phone now. Cut. Thank you.
All right. We need to have a meeting.
I'm afraid I've got a little bit of bad news.
Oh, do you need to leave us?
No, it's concerning the boys on the set, disabled boys.
Mm-hmm.
As you know, I represent the protection of the disabled community.
Mm, right? Yes, we're very happy to have you here.
I feel and they feel, even though we haven't had a chance to see any of the filming that you've shot so far, that it would be best in the interests of the two disabled lads that we withdraw them from the project.
Oh, no, see, that's going to affect my funding.
And yes,
we can't do the shoot if we don't have the funding.
Yes, but it is our project, and we are overriding you. Get proper actors and take Darren and James off the set.
Oh, well,
immediately.
I'll have a bit of a think about it.
No, it's immediate.
Because I can't afford to lose my funding, so thank you.
Can I get 260 chicks then?
You can get whoever you like, as long as they're not from the disabled community.
Okay. Thank you very much. Make me happy.
Right.
If they're not making it funny, I cannot change them. They had to change themselves. If they not working on funny on TV, it's their fault because they lost, lots and lots of life.
OK, what are we going to do?
Huh?
Too old.
Huh?
Too black.
Huh?
Too ginger.
Huh?
No, too old. All right, but too old. Too sexy looking.
That's it. I don't think this is going to work.
All right.
We need to do something else.
I'll leave it up to you, eh?
We need to get serious about this. So that's two now, yeah? We've got two?
Yeah, two. Yeah. Marvellous. She's good.
Who's paying for this?
I'll get back to you.
I'm going. Just while everyone's asleep. The funding's fallen through, so I've had enough. See ya.
Down on the tour. I'm Cindy.
And I'm Stacey. And today we are... we're solving mysteries.
And what are we solving a mystery of?
A monster. A scary monster. Just behind us here, I think.
And we're excited.
Oh, very excited, yeah.
Pat! Very good. Good work. Happy with that?
These girls are good looking, but they don't know solve mystery like me and Darren. These girls don't know how to solve mystery like me and Darren do.
They're only young beautiful girl. They're young. They're not clever like us. They're beautiful. They're in the bikini. So what?
So when are we getting paid?
Yeah, we haven't been paid yet.
Okay, who's paying? Girlie, where are you?
Malcolm, it's Simone. Do you take credit card?
Heavy.
I got about halfway home and I was thinking about it in the car and I realised, no, I'm a producer. This is what I do. I have to support my director, even if it means using my own money, my own credit cards. But I'm here. I'm here to support Malcolm and his vision. I might, you know, help him a bit, shape things, but we're going to make this the best show that we possibly can.
I was thinking that perhaps what your brother Gordy thinks is a love story
yeah,
might not be what your mum thinks is a love story. Mm. And we might try and write it the way your mum might like it.
Yeah?
Yeah? Mm. So I'll leave them with you. You have a bit of a read.
You come back to me later.
Yeah, later.
I want you back. I lost Mum 5 years ago. She went in 2005. Best mum in the world. Best friend you ever have. Best friend you ever have in your pocket. She's a good mum. I'm sad because she's gone. She left. That's my mum. She loved love stories, loved dramas, and loved mysteries. Never got over it, but she... gone. Very interesting. Oh. Oh, yeah. That's good, that. Oh, that was a pain. Sexual tensions. Ooh. I like that one.
What do you got?
We might have got something for you.
Yeah?
Perfect. Oh, we've been wanting to use this for ages. Look at that. That is going to be
but
awesome.
This movie is...
The girls are going to love it.
The movie's all about love, not porno. No rough stuff. Not rough stuff.
Yeah, love, yeah.
Love, yeah. Romance, being love.
So yeah. You don't want to use this?
No. You put that away, put it on your bed or under the pillow, because we don't want to do that.
Right.
It's going well. Just see you later.
No worries.
Well, we could go swimming in the river. We are dressed for the occasion.
Cut! You girls getting it wrong. I don't want this. What are you doing?
How are we getting it wrong?
What do you mean we're getting it wrong? I don't understand.
Love and romance.
But what do you mean romance? We don't know about romance.
Oh, what are you doing? I don't like it. Okay, put your head together. Think about it.
My head together? We didn't even know. This was never in the brief.
No, I've had enough. Sorry.
That's not enough.
Hey, walk off. Come back here, you pretty girls.
What's going on? The girl's coming back?
Oh, yes, it was just a disaster, a shambles, a farce. Malcolm's incompetence. What he's done will now reflect upon the rest of the disabled community. So, my committee and I myself have decided that we can only take the one action that's left open to us.
Rolling!
Action!
Cyril and his committee have decided that Malcolm is sacked. He's not directing anymore. Cyril's going to take over that role. But, you know, it's okay. Malcolm's going to stay around on set. I've made sure of that. He's going to do a bit of production assisting, maybe some of the catering, gophering, that sort of thing. So he's still here. He'll still be helping to realise the vision, which is very important. The good thing is that Cyril is disabled. He's in a wheelchair. So from my point of view, for marketing, publicity, it's great. Visually, it's going to be a really good disability for us, I think. So, you know, hard day, but we've pushed through and I think it's going to be okay.
I don't want to do an external mimicking. I want to try to find the essence of the person. I think spending time together researching and then working from the inside out is much more truthful and results in something much better. I thought maybe we could hang out a little bit together. What do you think?
No.
Ah.
Well, I tend to find the suit, the clothes, the feeling, the look. And I put the clothes on and I get the feeling. And I understand the character. I understand the way he holds his face, the tone of the voice. And I put the suit on and...
Action!
Welcome to the Mystery Down Under Tour. I am Darren, and this is James.
We're gonna solve mysteries and change people's lives.
Cut.
I think they're taking the mickey off us. They're not funny. James not like that at all. He do not see him. He do not live with him. I do. I live with James. And James do not act like that at home. And how dare him do that to James and he do not see him at all? He gone too far, I reckon.
It's not right fair for an actor to play because I can play myself. If it's on it. Once I want to play me, they can just take me because I'm right here. I can play a bit. Yeah, I'm a good person, yeah.
The actors and I have decided that so they can focus more on their roles, that it'd be a lot easier if you three weren't on the set. So here's three tickets to go 10-pin bowling. Enjoy.
Thanks for nothing.
Malcolm's gone, which I'm pretty happy about because, well, no one told me Malcolm was disabled, basically. And I'm quite annoyed about it. I actually feel quite deceived. I mean, I don't know, like, almost became mates with the guy.
Good job. Not happy. Not happy one bit at all.
Hey, come back.
Hey, boy. Hey, boy. Hey, come on, Margaret. Get.
It's really devastating to lose Malcolm. You know, it's his vision. Cyril sent him off bowling, but I'm going to stay. I'm going to make sure that Malcolm's vision comes to fruition. So I'm here. I'm pushing forward.
Action!
Help! Help!
Killing is what he does, and killing is what he needs to do.
Move on, get another job. Find somewhere else to go. I have a shop, hot rod shop. Do hot rods. I like motor cars, hot rods. Nice hot rod cars in the front, pouring down the back. I can't run a bloody chook raffle. Haven't told Gordon nothing about my sack. The shit will hit the fan when he comes home.
Malcolm!
I'm crapped off. I lost my job. I want to get back in, but I've got the sack finished.
Yeah, Malcolm!
Gordon doesn't know I didn't finish it. But I got the sack. When he comes home, I just have to tell him. He doesn't know nothing about James or Darren. You can't do nothing about it. It's water in the creek.
Yeah.
What are you watching?
Hey, buddy. Your movie. Sing your girls and down.
Not with their pants. You like it?
Yeah, good.
You'd like blonde hair?
I like blonde hair.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, big.
Yeah, it's good, Gordon.
Yeah, that's good, yeah.
What shape?
Used to fix, eh?
Yeah, they are. Knuckleheads, eh?
Knuckleheads, eh?
Yeah. He's my brother. My loving brother, that's it. Number one. He's my brother and myself. Everyone can A off.
We did not find anything. I'd not really care if I'm famous or not. What is famous? Famous, not everything. I'm still going to explore your mystery and find things. That is my passion, to look for something, go somewhere where men never gone before, and if I cannot find anything, I go back to my own normal life.
Oh, I'm actually finished with mysteries. I feel like I can now just move on with my life and do some new stuff. Yeah. Probably, I'll think of something. Make my own comedy show. Like, probably tell jokes to my audience about things that happened, like why the chick crossed the road and why did the rocket take off and why did the oven explode. I tell all these jokes about things, fill the room with laughing gas, make the whole room one load laugh on the jokes. I'm telling them jokes. The girls, it'd be okay if I don't find any girlfriends. It'd be okay. Because I don't really need a girlfriend. I can just cope. I can cope if I stay single. Yeah. Because you gotta buy stuff for them all the time, and I gotta be around them all the time. Yeah. And they probably take money from, and they take stuff from you all the time, and they steal stuff from you. Yeah, I don't need one.
I miss my mum. Oh well. Miss Darren James that much. Yeah. They're pain in the ass. They make you frustrated. Make me upset, but I still miss them.
Two Australian actors are missing tonight in Deep Forest, north of the Hawkesbury River.
Former A-list celebrities Barry S. Gibson and Clifford Phelps failed to return from filming a TV series in remote bush territory on Thursday. Ooh. Disability activist Win. Cyril Turner and three members of his film crew are also missing. Quite simply, they never should have been there. The danger is
clearly marked. The mountain's viewing platforms are cordoned off. Hello, Darren. What do you want?
Are you watching the news?
Yeah, I'm watching bloody news, yeah.
They're missing.
Okay.
SES volunteers and local police stepped up the search this morning, but family, friends and the actor's agents fear the worst.
Looks like another bloody mystery to solve, eh?
Malcolm, can we go to the strip club this time?
Bloody hell, we go.
Yeah, come on, come on. Let's go. Yeah, we got the yo-yo.
Hasn't bite twice thing. What did he bite?
Fortunately, David is wearing
cut. 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 Three days. Job is done. But James and Darren, two special boys. I love Darren. Get fucked. Cut.